time for our final segment on this Monday morning. We have Shine in the studio. We're going to talk about some health matters. Good morning. How was your weekend?
Good morning. My weekend was... I exercise a lot again.
Oh my gosh.
I exercise with my sister.
Oh, okay.
My own sister. Mm-hmm. She's 2 years younger than me. Mm-hmm. And she's very into fitness nowadays. And whenever we work out together, we do some hardcore weightlifting.
Are you serious?
Because we can spot each other to do as heavy as we can.
Wow, how cool is that? I don't know if my sister's listening. My sister and I, we don't work out together. We only eat together. That's our workout. Talking and lifting our chopsticks or fork. does she follow like the same routine as you, or does she like exercise differently?
She started working out with me when mm-hmm. I came back from the States. So we worked out together for like 4 months, uh-huh. like, almost every day.
Ah.
And ever since then, she's been doing it by herself for like 3 years so far.
Ooh.
And yeah, like pretty much the same routine, but nowadays she's doing like heavier routine. And yeah, but her work schedule is like kind of random. Her workout schedule is random as well, so whenever we have like time together, mm-hmm. then we try to do it together, like we try to make it.
Yeah. Well, you mentioned that her schedule is kind of random, but the fact that she still finds time, mm-hmm. I mean, I would imagine that if you kind of have like a irregular schedule, it might, you know, make working out kind of more difficult.
Yeah, it certainly is more difficult, but it is still possible because, you know, when you have your like work shift, mm-hmm. you can you plan your workout schedule like around your work schedule.
Yes, true.
So yeah, today's topic is when is the best time to exercise?
Oh, actually, a lot of people, there's a lot of debate out there from what I mm-hmm. understand. I mean, so when is the best time to exercise?
Well, there's a simple and honest answer for the best time to exercise is when you will work out. So like when you will commit to it, mm-hmm. and when you won't have much excuses, mm-hmm. and then when you will have less distraction, that would be the best time.
Mm-hmm.
It also depends on your fitness goal.
Like
you want to lose fat,
mm-hmm.
you want to gain mass,
mm-hmm.
you want to perform better, all the athletes,
yes.
or you simply want to do it for your health.
Mm.
Or like your lifestyle, including eating schedule and work schedule.
Right.
So it all depends on your goal, your lifestyle, mm-hmm. and your preference too. So, like, all the debates out there, like, mm-hmm. you have to discern what is the best for you.
Right. Mm. It's not the same for everybody, apparently. Mm. Well, a lot of our listeners out there, they work, let's say, a traditional work mm-hmm. week. For example, from, let's say, 9 to 6 or something similar to that.
Mm.
And maybe, you know, summer's here. They mm-hmm. want to look good for summer, right? Fit into that swimsuit. Maybe they're trying to lose weight. So what's, like, the best time to exercise for people like that?
Well, in this case, you have two options.
Okay.
Either early in the morning before you go to work,
mm-hmm.
or 3 or 4 hours after having dinner.
Oh, after. 3 to 4 hours after.
Yeah, because you want to digest the food you ate.
Mm-mm-mm.
So we're going to, you know, go deep into that. Depending on how it works better for you, either you're a morning person or evening person, you can still find time to exercise.
True.
Yeah, I guess you're clearly a morning person, aren't you?
Well, I wouldn't say I'm like thrilled about the fact that I have to wake up 5 a.m., but my body's so used to it now, mm-hmm. so like I can almost wake up without an alarm clock now. So,
nice.
Right, so how does early morning exercise work?
Well, if you want to exercise regularly, choosing mm-hmm. morning exercises makes it easier to stick with your intention and get into a habit.
Mm.
Just like you said, like you now it's a habit to, you know, wake up early in the morning.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So morning exercises are less likely to affect your schedules and everyday emergencies.
Mm.
Like you have birthday parties or a huishi.
Oh, that's true.
If you find it hard to make time for exercise throughout the day,
mm-hmm.
or like every time you want to exercise, there is something coming up, you can get up a little early in the morning, like not too early, like 30 minutes
okay.
in the morning, and to get into your workout.
Right.
Like the biggest benefit of morning exercises is that you can burn fat more efficiently.
Ooh.
So when you wake up in the morning from hours of sleeping, your body has digested all the food you ate the day before, and you're pretty much in a fasted state.
Okay.
So you have empty stomach.
Mm-hmm.
In this state, your insulin and glycogen level is very low, meaning there is less carbohydrate to burn, meaning your body is ready to burn fat in the morning.
Ah, so if we can do it in the morning, this would be really good.
Yeah, because your body uses energy from carbohydrate,
mm-hmm.
and then after it runs out carbohydrate, it burns fat,
mm-hmm.
and later it burns protein, which is muscle.
Mm.
So if you want to target the fat burning zone, right?
Yes, yes, yes. We are anti-fat. All right. So what kind of exercises are we talking about and for how long?
Mm. So the intensity and the duration of exercises is very important to maximize the benefits of morning exercise. So I want to say high intensity with shorter duration.
Oh.
So high intensity means it depends, but scale of 1 to 1 through 10, like 10 is the highest intensity, target about 7 or 8 that you could do.
Okay.
And shorter duration meaning 30 minutes is ideal. But even if you are like advanced, but no more than an hour, because then your body will use up the energy from fat and need to pull out the energy from protein, meaning your muscle to keep going, which means muscle loss.
We don't want to lose the muscle. We want to lose the fat, right?
So like warm-ups are very important in the morning as your muscles are at rest and all night. So, you know, when you wake up in the morning, you're achy and tight. So give yourself a warm-up period of at least 5 minutes of easy exercise before going into a higher intensity workouts. You don't want to like wake up and then do like burpees and like running and sprinting, right?
So
whether you work out at home, at the gym, or outdoor, make sure you warm up and drink some water before going into an exercise. So for example, I would do this. So like 1 minute of like gentle stretch and 4 minutes walking downstairs.
Okay.
And then 4 minutes of easy jog.
And
like, it's just like 5 minutes routine. So 1 minute squat, 4 minute jog. 1 minute squat, 1 minute push-ups, 4 minute jog.
Ah.
1 minute crunches, four minute jog. And then one minute lunges, 4 minute walk. And then 1 minute plank. So it's like cool down in the end.
Right.
So like it's interval cardio with like full body toning exercise.
Right.
You can make your own routine or even like turn on some YouTube video if you work out at
home.
That's
what I do at home.
Yeah.
I turn on YouTube on my smart TV. And I have to say the planks, people say, oh, like do a minute plank like it's no big deal. I couldn't even do 30 seconds in the beginning. I can do at least a minute now. But in the beginning, I couldn't do the plank for 30 seconds. It was insane.
Absolutely normal. You can build up, right?
All right. So let's move on because we have lack of time, to the evening. How about people who can't do it in the morning and they want to squeeze it in the evening? You said 3 to 4 hours after dinner, right?
That's actually my case because I have group training until 9 p.m. And I stay active like that for the most evenings. So it's hard for me to wake up early in the morning again to exercise, though I want to try. I'm sure many of our listeners fall into this case. A key for evening exercise is to finish eating 3 to 4 hours before you start working out, especially if you want to lose fat. If you exercise with a full tummy, your body will be busy digesting food and it takes longer for your body to get into the fat burning zone. So you probably have to work out for an hour to use up all the carbohydrate and then burning fat.
But so for example, if you want to start working out at 8 p.m., then you should finish eating by
like 4 to 5 p.m.
Ah, okay.
But in this case, try to eat a small meal even if you don't feel too hungry. It could be like a banana and pack of yogurt or some sweet potatoes and chicken salad. That's my menu. By the time you start exercising at 8 p.m., your insulin and glycogen level will drop to be ready to burn fat just like early morning. So if you feel hungry after your workouts, eat a hard-boiled egg and with a cup of warm tea, you know, like you should get some necessary protein while cutting down calorie intake. My case, I drink like a protein shake and that's it.
I see. Yeah. Very cool. What about for those people, like full-time moms or people working at home and they just got to squeeze it in whenever they can?
But like, for working moms or working at home, you have two options, either late morning or late afternoon. Just like that after eating breakfast or lunch, mm-hmm. like 3 to 4 hours later, you can, you know, it's the best time to exercise in this case.
Yes.
Because you have more time around those time.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, and then even, and especially in the late afternoon, you can avoid the midday crash.
Oh, yeah.
And save your save yourself from indulging in sweet snacks, because late in the afternoon,
yes,
you're a little bit tired, mm-hmm. and you want to eat some snack.
True.
And kwaja.
Mm.
Yeah, if you squeeze your exercise in this time, mm-hmm. you'll be able to avoid it.
Mm, sounds good. What I really learned a lot, especially the whole, you know, try to work out 3 to 4 hours after you've had your last meal. That's mm-hmm. very informative. So thank you so much, Shine, for talking about this today.
Okay, like I said in the beginning, the best time to exercise is when you will work out. Anytime you do, exercise will be beneficial to your health. So,
all right.
Today, start.
Start, right now. All right. Well, thank you, Shine. We'll check in with you again next week.
Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.
I'll be back after a commercial break.